We ended the last section a little bit deflated because we figured out that the MNIST training data of zeros versus non-zeros is in fact not linearly separable. But we also discovered that it's almost linearly separable. So if we could figure out a way to tweak our perceptron learning algorithm to learn a hyperplane that mostly separates the target classes, it could still be a strong predictive model. A simple but effective way to do this is the pocket algorithm, where as you make weight updates, you keep track of the best performing weight vector, placing it in your pocket, and unveiling it at the end of some predetermined number of iterations. This idea was originally described by Stephen Gallant in 1990, but I suggest we make a couple tweaks to the algorithm he proposed. The algorithm I challenge you to implement goes like this. Initialize wpocket equal to the zero vector, wcurrent equal to the zero vector, wpocket accuracy equal to zero, and wcurrent accuracy equal to zero. Then set accuracy current equal to accuracy of wcurrent applied to the full training data. Next, if accuracy current equals one, meaning the current weight vector does a perfect job of separating the target classes in the training data, we return wcurrent. Otherwise, if accuracy current is greater than accuracy pocket, we set wpocket equal to wcurrent and accuracy pocket equal to accuracy current, meaning if the current weight vector does a better job than the weight vector in our pocket, we update what's in our pocket. Then we identify a random training sample such that wcurrent misclassifies it, and we use it to update wcurrent with the canonical update procedure. Next, we repeat steps 2 through 4 until some stopping condition is met. For example, we might run 1,000 iterations. And then lastly, we return wpocket, which should be the best weight vector we found. So pause the video and see if you can refactor the perceptron class from the last section to use the pocket algorithm in case the training data is not linearly separable. Here's my implementation. I start by initializing a bunch of stuff, like a random number generator, x1, wcurrent, wpocket, accuracy current, and accuracy pocket. Then I set up a for loop to run max updates iterations. Next, I use wcurrent to make predictions on all the samples in x, and then I measure its accuracy rate. Then I do a couple checks. So if accuracy current is 1, meaning the hyperplane defined by wcurrent perfectly separates the target classes, I set wpocket equal to wcurrent, and then I break out of the for loop. Alternatively, if accuracy current is better than accuracy pocket, I set wpocket equal to wcurrent, and accuracy pocket equal to accuracy current. Assuming we're still in the for loop because we haven't found a hyperplane that perfectly separates the data, the next thing I do is I pick a random training sample such that wcurrent misclassifies it, and I use it to update wcurrent with the same update procedure as the canonical perceptron learning algorithm. Once we're out of the for loop, I simply update the class attributes self.yClasses equal to yClasses and self.w equal to wpocket, which is the best performing weight vector we found. Let's test our model on the unseparable 2D dataset. You can see how it did a pretty reasonable job of finding a separating line. Now let's test it on MNIST zeros versus non-zeros. I'll set verbose equals true here so we can see how the model improves quickly at first and slowly towards the end. The takeaway here is that even though we can't perfectly separate zeros and non-zeros with a hyperplane, we can get pretty darn close. Now, we still don't have a multi-class classifier. So given an image, I can't tell you if it's a 1 or a 5 or a 9. All I can tell you is if it's a 0 or not a 0. So the obvious next question is, how do we extend our binary classifier into a multi-class classifier?